Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dan Weinberger here, CEO, co-founder of Morpheus Network, here with your first quarter report for 2024. Super excited to give you guys this report. We're firing on all cylinders when it comes to the community, things that's going on with the validator network and trust.supply or trust M&W, things going on with the team as well, different projects we've implemented, top of the funnel, middle of the funnel stuff. So lots of stuff to update you on. We have some updates from team members as well. So I'm gonna try to fire right through this. Super excited, so let's get right into it. First of all, the validator network, bringing in a ton of new integrations. I mean, pushed through trust.supply, a massive enterprise, one of our top clients will be pulling in some mainframe data through trust.supply as well. Mr. V, he knows about a new project we're working on for a client to validate an absolute ton of data through trust.supply as well. So validator network, transaction-wise, growing as it should. We're actually growing out the amount of validators as well. We opened up some more space for more validators to join the network. That's been great. We've had some more people join as well. Beta phase is going really, really well. One thing we are very excited about is the next phase for masternodes. Obviously, there's a lot of new stuff going on behind the scenes with the team. There's a lot of stuff in development, a lot of stuff with regulation, stuff happening on it, you know, all around the news as well when it comes to regulation around crypto in general, but even masternodes and you know, decentralized structures in general. So excited to tell you guys more about that. A ton of stuff in the works. Thank you so much for the validators who are part of the network right now. You know, keep on validating and excited to grow out the network and the transactions as well. Some amazing projects we can tell you about. One project that, you know, we've mentioned it a few times in the past without being able to mention the name of the actual client. In this case, it's a national government, MNCCI, the government of Mongolia. We've implemented a certificate of origin validation system for the national government of Mongolia. This is now a battle-tested solution for the government. We're talking to other potential validation solutions for national governments, for companies. What this does specifically is allow a document from the government itself, certificate of origin, to be validated on-chain, of course. The document's submitted. You know it's the valid certificate of origin right from the government itself. Excited to have that not only built, not only contractually signed, but implemented and in use right now. Very excited about that. Another very exciting project, more so in the middle of the sales pipeline, I guess you can say, is a transport company leveraging our BOLs. Our BOLs for QR code scans, for geolocation, for uploading documentation as well. What's so great about that project is brought into us by Matthew, one of our amazing new AEs, our amazing new salespeople, formerly of Echo Logistics, now proudly of Morpheus Network. So great job by Matthew. He has this company working with a pilot, and after the pilot, we'll look to implement as well. And again, that brings it right back to Trust M&W. What happens when all these different validations occur? We're going to be pulling that into the Trust M&W, Trust.supply network being validated by our masternodes themselves. Very excited about that. And again, more announcements coming on that network and how it ties into other solutions that we have, including this, you know, potential implementation for Matthew. Congratulations on that. Another amazing project as well. This is more on the top of the sales pipeline. This is going to different events that we've been going to. I actually went to an SAP event in Las Vegas. SAP throws on these amazing events. This is at the Hilton Hotel. And what they do is they allow us to meet all the different SAP AEs, the account executives that sell the different solutions, SAP certified products like Morpheus Network, to the various clients that use SAP, which is the number one ERP provider in the world. On top of that, we get to meet the different corporates and discuss the solutions face to face. Our middleware, how we pull in data for different validation systems, whether it's from a TMS system or a WMS, from an ERP system, use that PO data to populate documentation, create a ton of automation all the way down the supply chain. Already discussing some initial projects with a fiber optic manufacturer as well, as a laundry manufacturer. What's great about the laundry manufacturer, they manufacture in Asia, Europe, and North America, ship all around the world. So a ton of compliance, a ton of shipping documentation, a ton of manual steps that they take right now. As well, all of these projects, as mentioned, have to be back-end validated by Trust.supply. So again, huge thank you to the validators, huge thank you to the community. Excited for, you know, moving on with the community and Trust.supply, as well as with the clients and our team. Thank you so much, guys. Amazing first quarter. I'll throw it over to Mr. Noam Eppel.
Thank you so much, Dan, and happy Friday, everyone. I am recording this video from beautiful New York. Dan and I are in New York for a research seminar called The Decentralization of the Real World, put on by Unruly Capital. What I like about this research event, this seminar, is that it has a focus on applying decentralization concepts and tools to real use cases. Rather than only focusing on technology, the seminar is discussing how to apply it to industries such as manufacturing and, of course, supply chain. It's an event put on by Unruly Capital. There's a fantastic group of startup founders and VCs and devs and engineers. And so it's a fantastic event here in beautiful New York. I'm excited to put together this video for you. At Morpheus Network, there has been, you know, a flurry of activity and progress and updates and growth and so forth. And sometimes it is hard to keep everyone up to date on what's going on. So we thought that we'd put together a video where we would do a rapid fire through some of our exciting updates, and so I'm excited to put this video together for you. I have a list of 10 items that I wrote down that I wanted to discuss. The very first item is around our communication. So we put in a lot of effort into our communication. The amount of content we are putting out has increased dramatically. A big thanks to James and Nikhil and the marketing team there. We put a lot of efforts into our socials, AMA, making ourselves available, having dedicated resources in Telegram to listen and respond to your chats and comments and feedback and so forth. And we want to continue putting a lot of efforts into our communication. We're looking to expand the team in that respect, looking to produce more content. This video today is a great example of something that we're trying to do to help increase the communication. And related to communication, though, I wanted to mention one very, very important point. Dan, in his video, mentioned a brand new project, new in the sense that it's the first time we are publicly announcing it, and it is the project that we did for a government client, the Mongolian government, certifying COOs, Certificate of Origins, on the blockchain. This is a great example of applying blockchain for the real world. But my point is that we've been working on that project for about a year, a full year, and only now do we have the permission to actually speak about it publicly. And so this is one of the challenges of our company when, you know, we have a community of supporters that are hungry for news. Sometimes, you know, there are news and partnerships and events that we simply can't speak about. Trust me, if it was up to just me and Dan and the team, we would be saying everything. But we have to be very careful. We have to honor our partnerships and honor NDAs. And so, you know, thank you for your patience. The Mongolian government contract is just one example of something that we've been working on for a while, but it does take a while before we can actually speak about it publicly. So I wanted to reiterate that point, and thank you for your patience, as sometimes we have to wait before making these announcements. That's number one. Number two, I wanted to mention our board of advisors. So over the past, you know, few months or half a year or so, we've slowly and carefully assembled a team of all-stars. We have 8 fantastic board of advisor members. And these are people that we've known through the industry, people that we've met through some of our accelerator programs we've gone through. And we approached 8 to ask if they can join our board of advisors, and they all said yes. Recently, I was speaking to a VC friend, and he said one sign of a great project is the ability to attract all-stars. And I think our board of advisors is a great example of that, being able to attract senior supply chain people and tech people. And we've got a couple people from Google and the industry and so forth. And recently we had our very first meeting with them. And I can't tell you how valuable it is to have a group of people around us as a sounding board to discuss, you know, issues and hear their advice. It's been tremendous. So that first group board of advisor meetings was very, very successful, and I look forward to the next one. Number three, product roadmap. So this is perhaps the longest item on my list, but in the interest of time, I have to keep this very short. Right now we have our middleware platform, and it's been very successful. It's won multiple awards, and but we have one product. This year, we're looking to launch a number of new products, and we have various names for our products. The first one's called Speed, and we have additional products coming down the pipeline: Automate, Vision, Protect, and a few more. And what's exciting is that never before in our history have we had the technology that we have today, as powerful as it is today, whether we're talking about blockchain or IoT or machine learning or various APIs we can tap into. Never before have we had that incredible capability as accessible and affordable as we have it today. And so part of the reason we established this company was to figure out how to leverage that amazing technology and apply it to the supply chain industry to eliminate some of the common supply chain challenges that the industry normally faces. And so our one middleware product has been so successful, but what we want to do is accelerate that by launching a number of products. The first one that's coming out is Speed. Every one of these products will have a common architecture, the same UI, UX, one login to access everything. And all of these products are going to be on the same foundation, including on Trust, our Trust Masternode system. So that's exciting. Each product is going to be feeding transactions into the Trust layer. So I can talk about that product roadmap for a couple more hours, but I wanted to mention that. The third thing I wanted to talk about is Justin Rush. I wanted to take a minute to celebrate him in a sense. Justin Rush is another all-star we brought on the team to be our new head of products, to manage the development and launch and growth of those new products we're looking to release. Justin Rush is someone that we were able to hire over from Amazon. He was a senior global supply chain manager at Amazon, and he's another example of an all-star we were able to attract over to our team. And he's been fantastic. He is similar to Dan. He is a workhorse, and it's so good to see him join our team and see how well he's been doing. So thank you to Justin Rush. I was in Las Vegas with him not too long ago at the Google Cloud Next conference, and we had a chance to do some work together down there and really learn more about some of Google's amazing new latest tools and APIs. So huge, huge things coming with that product roadmap. Number five, I wanted to mention Paddle AI. So Paddle is a great payment processing platform. They're very much focused on SaaS products, and they have a program called Paddle AI Launchpad. And through this Launchpad, it is an accelerator similar to some of the accelerators we've gone through, like the Google Startup Accelerator and Plug and Play. And through this Paddle AI program, you get access to various experts and content and advice and support. So we were recently accepted into that program. We've had our first few events this past week fantastic content, an amazing group of other young startups and founders and so forth. So that's been a great program, and I'm very excited that we've been able to get into that program. And that's going to be very helpful with our new products that we're launching this year. Number six, the website. So we're looking to release the website finally in coordination with our first speed product launch. We're timing it so they're both going to be released at the same time, which is quite exciting. The website's been taking a while for sure, and but it's looking great, and our online brand needed a refresh, so I'm excited that that is ready to launch. Number seven, wanted to mention that we passed yet another security assessment. Perhaps exciting for some people and not so exciting for others, but security is so important for our company. We put a tremendous amount of effort into that, and it's great that we just passed another security assessment by a company called Orpheus, similar to Morpheus, which is interesting, but this one's the company's called Orpheus, and they did a full top to bottom assessment of some of our servers, and glad to say we passed that. Number eight, wanted to mention conferences. So the team, especially this year, will be attending a number of different conferences, supply chain industry conferences, as well as tech and crypto conferences. A few coming up are the New York event that Dan and I are at right now, Consensus, Bitcoin Nashville. And so if you're attending any of these events, please do reach out. Another one is Vivitech. And I wanted to take a minute and talk about Vivitech. In Toronto, in Canada, there's a program called Scale AI. And Scale AI is another kind of accelerator incubator that's very focused on developing Canadian artificial intelligent companies. And through Scale AI, we applied and were accepted into a program that takes Canadian companies to Vivitech in Paris. Vivitech is Europe's largest startup tech conference. And so there's a number of Canadian companies going there as part of this Canadian trade delegation. And Scale AI and the Canadian Trade Commissioner and the Paris Embassy or Trade Commissioner is going to be setting up a lot of meetings and introducing us to a lot of companies in France and Europe looking for supply chain tech. So it's a great opportunity, and that's coming up later this month. Very excited about Vivitech in Europe. If you're attending any major crypto conferences or industry events, please do let us know in Telegram or Twitter X, because it is very possible that one of the team members or Dan or myself will be there, and we always love meeting our community members in person. Number nine, we are sponsoring an event at Consensus this year called a Web3 Days Party, Consensus 2024 in Austin. This is another effort by us to connect with our community, connect to other crypto projects, and I hope to see many of you at Consensus, and we'll drop a link to the registration page to sign up for our Web3 Days Party. We are co-hosting that with Dimitra as well, so I really hope to see some of you guys there. Last thing I wanted to mention, which is number 11, is that we're still hiring. We continue to grow, continue to look for all-stars. We have a job post on LinkedIn, and our hiring philosophy, like there's two ways to hire. One is when you have a open job position, such as project manager, and then you go out and you look for project managers. That's one hiring approach. The other approach is rather than looking for a specific role, You look for a specific person. And that's our approach. We just look for all-stars, people who have supply chain experience and tech experience, who are all-stars, who can wear many hats. And we know if we have all-stars on our team, we can then find the right role. So that's very much our philosophy. Look for the best people, and then we can figure out the roles and responsibilities after. But we're still hiring, still growing, and hopefully continue to strengthen our team. Lastly, I wanted to close by kind of reiterating why we do what we do. You know, there are a ton of great projects out there in companies and crypto companies focused on all sorts of things. We truly, truly believe that if you fix supply chain, you fix the world. And when supply chain improves, like within a country or globally, it has so many different positive impacts on the economy, on jobs, on reducing the price of goods, on making goods and products and food more available to people, even a huge impact on the environment. So that's why we say if you fix supply chain, you fix the world. We're so thankful for you guys who are with us on our journey. We're very, very focused on creating something, you know, spectacular here, a company that's going to be successful for a long, long, long time. We're so grateful for you guys to be with us on our journey. We truly, truly value each and every one of you. And, you know, we love that you're vocal. We love your comments and suggestions and ideas. We do listen. So thank you for that. And I want to say to everyone, you know, stay safe, stay healthy, much love, and thank you for listening to this talk. And with that, I will pass it on to James. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan and Noam, for those updates. I've got quite a bit to go over myself. I've got updates concerning our new social platforms, some updates to our marketing team. We've hired some new agencies and some new ninjas that I want to tell you about. Also, Dan will be coming back at the end of the video with another update that you'll definitely want to hear about. So that's coming at the tail end of the entire presentation. But first, I want to share with you a video never seen before for the first time. This is our primer introduction video to our new suite of products called Middleware.Supply. Enjoy.
Morpheus Network, a pioneering force in the realm of supply chain technology, has proudly announced the launch of Middleware.Supply, a groundbreaking suite of solutions tailored to transform global supply chain management. This suite comprises Speed.Supply, Vision.Supply, and Ships.Supply, each designed to address specific aspects of the supply chain with precision and innovation. Middleware.Supply emerges against a backdrop of increasingly complex supply chain challenges, offering a beacon of efficiency, streamlined operations, and reliability. Speed.Supply, the first component of this suite, is crafted to simplify complex logistics, ensuring timely deliveries while enhancing trust and reliability between businesses and consumers. It adopts a no-code integration framework, incorporates real-time tracking capabilities, and employs blockchain technology for secure, immutable data storage. This triad of features allows businesses to seamlessly integrate with existing systems, providing instant insights into every stage of the supply chain and ensuring data integrity and regulatory compliance. Beyond mere functionality, Speed.Supply democratizes supply chain efficiency through automation and digitization. It drastically reduces manual labor, accelerates operations, and lowers costs, all while making compliance with ever-evolving regulations simpler. Additionally, it bolsters resilience by early identification of vulnerabilities, facilitates collaboration through real-time data exchange, and enhances coordination by breaking down operational silos. In a leap forward, Morpheus Network introduces Vision.Supply, enhancing the capabilities of Speed.Supply with advanced data analytics, AI, and machine learning-enhanced predictive modeling. Vision.Supply transforms vast amounts of data into actionable insights, enabling businesses to preemptively optimize supply chain operations, forecast trends, anticipate market demands, and make informed decisions to mitigate risks and capitalize on opportunities. Completing the trio, Ships.Supply is specifically designed for the maritime sector, integrating seamlessly with Speed.Supply to provide real-time maritime tracking and IoT capabilities. It offers unmatched transparency and control over maritime logistics, enabling precise monitoring of ship locations, cargo conditions, and delivery times. With IoT technology, Ships.Supply ensures the integrity and safety of goods, particularly crucial for perishable items, hazardous materials, and high-value shipments, thereby redefining efficiency and security in maritime logistics. The unveiling of Middleware.Supply by Morpheus.Network marks not just the introduction of innovative products, but signifies a transformative step towards redefining the future of supply chain management. This advanced technology suite empowers businesses to confidently and agilely navigate the complexities of modern supply chains, setting a new standard for efficiency, resilience, and strategic advantage in a competitive, complex global marketplace. With Middleware.Supply, Morpheus.Network reaffirms its commitment to driving innovation and sustainability in supply chain management, empowering teams to optimize operations with unparalleled ease and effectiveness.
How cool was that, right? Middleware.Supply. We'll be releasing Speed.Supply first, along with Trust.Supply. And just to clarify, Trust.Supply is the new branding for Trust MNW. For those of you who log in and manage our master nodes, you are familiar with that. So we are rebranding that as Trust.Supply, consistent with our naming scheme. We'll also have Vision.Supply and Ships.Supply, all part of the middleware suite. Now, with that said, once those are released in short order, right after that, we are releasing new suites of products specifically for some of our customers around their verticals. So we'll have Auto.Supply, Space.Supply, Frontier.Supply, all of those are suites of products like Speed.Supply, Ships.Supply, Vision.Supply, specially tooled and optimized for those industries. So those will also be coming out this year. Very excited about that. We believe that is going to be exactly what our enterprise customers will need for their next version. So that consider that Morpheus.Network 3.0. So I want to bring you up to date with a couple of marketing developments, new hires, new technologies that we've started using to improve our communications with both community and also, of course, generate leads, enterprise leads, and SME, small to medium enterprise customers. The first one is we have brought on a team out of Sydney, Australia, headed up by Sadaf, who is working on hacking our socials, right? Getting very familiar with the algorithms that are ever changing for Twitter X and for Meta and for LinkedIn, and trying to optimize our messaging around keywords to stimulate growth. And that is our prime focus right now, is to try to influence other projects, get the word out about us, and use socials to their maximum potential. So Sadaf is heading up that team with her skilled team of writers and content creators. So you'll see a lot more of that in our socials. We also have hired a PR firm, Jillian and Lisa out of Ireland. They are helping us get into crypto trades like Cointelegraph and CoinMarketCap. They're also getting us on podcasts and onto panels and keynote speaking positions at events and conferences that Noam had alluded to or spoke about in his video. So we have a lot more of that. So you'll see a lot more Morpheus.Network in the trades, being talked about by crypto leadership. There'll be a lot more thought leadership around our real-world assets and DePIN solutions, and how we fit into the ecosystem. All of this, of course, to, drive growth in community numbers and supporters of the project. So Jillian, Lisa, you may, they will be contributing to a new platform that we're using to get the word out called Paragraph, paragraph.xyz. You may be familiar with it. It is a Web3-enabled blog. So we found that, our Medium blog is great, but we want to specifically use that for our SEO, SEM around lead generation for new customers, right? New users of our product. So we're going to use Paragraph to communicate with the crypto community. It's also going to serve as our mailing list. So we can now post pertinent, up-to-date, real-time information on Paragraph, and it will be delivered to your inbox as well as into your wallet messaging service, right? Even better, you can start collecting our content that we put on there as an NFT, and they'll be limited to 23. There is no cost for that, just the gas on Polygon to collect it. And we're going to have some fun with that. Robzy, also a great addition to our team. You may know him from being one of our admins over in Telegram. Is doing an amazing job helping me manage these socials, helping me optimize them. As you know, he single-handedly with the help of Magnus and Triple Dutch helped us with getting Discord optimized, and he is managing Discord now. He is certainly doing a fantastic job. We've got some great features over there. And of course in Telegram, seems like he's always awake and always on point. So thank you very much, Robzy. Robzy is, for me, absolutely invaluable. He is an incredibly important member of my team. Thank you very much, Robzy, for all the hard work you do. And then other additions, we are bringing on Warpcast. Warpcast is like Twitter, crypto Twitter. It is Web3 enabled as well. It is optimized for mobile, but there is a desktop app for it. And you can, we'll be feeding some of the content, well, all the content from Paragraph out into Warpcast as well. The point there, of course, is to be a big fish in a small pond, influence some other projects that are out there, and see if we can get some new community members just based on our wealth of content that we put out on Warpcast. And then Riverside is really cool. Riverside.fm is a really cool platform that we'll be doing podcasts with. So our AMAs will be the form of podcast now. We're also going to interview crypto and supply chain leaders and customers and users of our platform. We're going to have a whole series of short and long form videos produced via Riverside. And then we'll share those, of course, to Paragraph. And to Medium and to Twitter and all the other socials, depending on which the content is, whether it's supply chain or crypto. So we're very excited about that. That's really going to help our engagements. And of course, we'll continue to keep the regular cadence of AMAs going for you guys, so you can continue to ask us questions that we continue to answer. We certainly want to always be approachable and accessible to your questions. So that's it for our technologies. We are going to make a couple of changes with TG. Robzy and I are working on that. We find that Telegram has, it's no longer the preferred channel for crypto projects. Discord really is where we want to have our conversations. It's where we want to engage with you guys. It's where we want to answer your questions, where we want to have our FAQs and all of our customer support, the node support, all should be in Discord. It is just a much more secure platform. It allows, obviously, you have to be authenticated to join. And so though the numbers may not be as robust as they are in Telegram, that is where we want to have our conversation. So Telegram, unfortunately, we feel like it's doing more harm than good these days. Paragraph is intended for community's input as well. So we welcome your content. If you've got something to write, send it over to Robzy. He's acting as an editor, and we'll certainly get that out there. Also, he's going to be supporting the conversations in there. So again, thank you, Robzy, for that. So now we're going to turn it over to members of our team, starting with Mr. V, who's going to give us an update on some technology builds and some new developments. We're also going to hear from Merv and Matt and Hannah, Justin and Travis. All are going to come in and give you their updates of what they were working on in Q1 and what they hope to accomplish for Q2. And then, of course, Dan will wrap it up with the last big update that I'm sure you're all going to want to hear. So stay tuned for that. Don't skip ahead because this is some good content. Thanks for
good day, everyone. Here is Mr. V, and I have a brief video update for you here. So this year started with the silence, and the reason for that is that we are extremely busy here, and I hope Robzy and Triple Dutch keep you guys engaged. As the bull runs begin in the crypto industry, we've been inspired by what we can achieve entering into production or live mode, live mode with Trust M&W or Trust Supply. Now, what we are doing there is a significant infrastructure upgrade when it comes to performance, security, and also governance of all the operation that is happening. So what does it mean that previously in this beta mode, we tested a lot of parts of the system which would support the actual operation of the network. While there were fundamental implementation of logging of all the transactions through the different clients, we never put it to a real work up until what's gonna come in the few weeks. So we developed the ability to onboard any client in a self-serve mode through the external API, which would allow put into a work the entire validators network. And this is how you would see the change in your managed VPS and servers that you use when you run the desktop CLI. It will be imperative to keep CLI version up to date. And once we finish the production tests, which is gonna happen very, very soon, we are literally finished the staging tests of the system to allow clients to tap into the network. And we are testing right now the actual validation routine, the main algorithms, like pretty much every core operation before we push it to the production. So I expect it to be in May or maximum in June when we start putting into a stress all the hardware, all the systems that we have to provide what we have promised for the live environment. So the communication will be also way more intense once we get into that point. That would be more fun, more engaging. There is other features I would love to share, as you always know, but I can't. One thing I'll just give a teaser about, there might be, I would say, out of this world level of engagement if this feature went in, because it would make everyone absolutely addicted to what's happening in the platform on the daily basis. So I hope these are exciting news for you, and keep watching the Telegram. We'll provide you with what's gonna come next in the coming weeks. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. B. Exciting stuff. And do you sleep? Next up is Merv, our one of our senior account executives, to tell you about what he worked on last quarter and what he's working on right now. Merv?
Hello, guys. As some of you know, my name is Merv. I'm a senior account executive, and I was brought onto the Morpheus Network team in December of 2023. And we just wrapped up an amazing Q1. I wanted to take the time to share with you some amazing takeaways, some of the learning opportunities, and also our plans for Q2 and a little bit of the remainder of this year. We got the opportunity to speak with hundreds of senior leaders of Fortune 500 companies. And in that process, we also got to learn a lot more about their supply chain operations and how Morpheus Network's end-to-end solutions can help them improve and streamline their supply chain process. Two main key takeaways that I find to be the most valuable for a lot of these conversations was, number one, our workflow automations capabilities, and also our blockchain capabilities, number two, for tracking shipments, immutable data for regulatory purposes, document management, and also supporting ESG and sustainability initiatives. Those seem to be the key talking points that we had and what excited a lot of the prospective customers that we were speaking with. And I believe you'll see a lot of the conversations that we're currently having now in Q1 as well as Q2 will actually convert into an increased number of users and customers later on this year. As far as Q2, we have lots of exciting activities and news to share with you guys. You'll be seeing a lot more of the Morpheus Network team, especially the sales team, at conventions, trade shows, and also conferences, which means that you'll also be seeing a lot more of our CEO, Dan. He'll be engaged in a lot of thought leadership at these events as well. It'll give us an opportunity to also demo our product at a lot of these conventions before thousands and thousands of people, which we'll also have the opportunity to network with as a team. The next thing that I'm really excited about for Q2, Q3, and Q4, especially as early as Q2, is new SaaS product releases, spearheaded by Justin, our head of products. It is really a game changer. It is going to make life for the sales team amazingly easier. It will give us an opportunity to onboard customers a lot faster and onboard a significantly much more customers that will have the opportunity to use the Morpheus Network platform, and which is good news for the blockchain community because you'll get to see more activity and also more transactions. So I'm really, really excited about the work that Justin is doing. It aligns perfectly well with our sales and go-to-market strategies for this year. Can't wait to share the good news and the success of that product, which I'm sure we'll have tons of success to share with you guys in Q3. Thank you guys for supporting Morpheus Network, our ambitious goals to tackle global supply chain issues, and also our blockchain journey. And as Dan always says, if you fix supply chain, you fix the world. Thank you for your support, guys. Cheers.
Thank you, Mer. That is some great stuff. Looking forward to seeing some of those successes this quarter. Next up is Matthew. He's going to tell you a little bit about Bryant Trucking and what he's been working on with them. That pilot is going very, very well. We're excited about his successes.
Hello, everyone. My name is Matthew Stein, Senior Account Executive here at Morpheus Network, and I just wanted to give you a quick progress update on my last quarter. Over the past few months, I've engaged with several large grocery retail stores, discussing with them a number of unique challenges that they're having within the food document management solution. One of the insights and takeaways I was getting was that their data from their vendors is siloed. They're having it in different places and they're receiving it via email and some via the web. And they were looking for a solution to really optimize that and have their data centralized. I've been discussing a number of different options for them and excited to continue that in the next quarter as well. Beyond those retailers, I've been discussing and seeing opportunities within the full truckload space. What I've noticed is that a number of their backend solutions are manual, leading to inefficiencies and higher costs. And I've been discussing with them as well how we can automate and speed up and reduce costs on the back end for them too. Looking ahead, I'm excited to introduce some new industries that I think could benefit from automation, and looking forward to a great Q3. Thanks.
Thank you, Matthew. Next up is Hannah. Hannah this year was promoted from a business development representative to an account executive. And so we're very happy for her. She certainly deserves it. She has done an amazing job. If you remember, she's one of the first hires we've ever had. So she's been here for a very long time, maybe longer than I. She will also be at Consensus with me. Very excited about walking the floor with her. We're going to be focusing on this year talking to hardware companies, specifically crypto and technology, computer hardware companies, whether that be wallets or mining, hardware, steelhead, infrastructure. We know they all have supply chains. We want to be their solution. It makes sense. We've already been in a bunch of conversations with some companies, and we want to make sure that we press the flesh while we're there. So we'll hopefully have something to report with those successes. And we will be broadcasting live from Consensus. So tune in on Twitter Spaces. We'll be doing some live events there. And then we'll be posting pictures and videos and hopefully some interviews via Riverside in a blog format over on Paragraph, and casting that to your wallets through webcast or Warpcast rather, and through the socials. So without further ado, Hannah, take it away.
All right. So Last quarter started off really well. Now that I'm an account executive here, I was able to prioritize my targets a little bit more. And I thought, you know, what's an industry that I'm really interested in? And that's wellness. And there's a lot of, you know, subcategories under that umbrella, such as vitamins, supplements, you know, nutrition, sporting goods, fitness equipment, commercial, recreational, you name it. So things like that, that are very regulatory heavy, as well as other kind of alternative medicines. And that's been really exciting. I've been able to learn what some of their pain points are. And unfortunately, counterfeiting is one of the top issues, as well as not being able to be as dynamic as these companies would like, you know, in terms of supply chain issues. And, you know, a few things from last year are slowly but surely moving along. You know, plastic manufacturer in Asia, we're talking to a big consumer goods company in North Africa, and a few new opportunities in Europe from this past quarter, such as a pet food company and a portable modular office company. So really exciting stuff. You know, we really want to get out there and help them with their traceability issues. And that's really the biggest thing, is being able to provide people with the immutable sense of truth so they can trace their products, and their clients can too. So very exciting. I'm looking forward to this quarter.
Thank you, Hannah. The great stuff. Always love hearing from you. Next up is Travis, our head of projects. Also our head of customer success. You know, we are very lucky to have Travis. Travis, absolutely, his experience over at Amazon is greatly appreciated. He really does help us with our operations, keeping things sorted, documents everything, and single-handedly manages our FCL projects. And as you know, you've been watching over this year, FCL, we went from one small little solution to multiple solutions now. We are in a lot of their tech stack, not just their food service, but also managing their supply chains, both regionally and last mile. We've got some great new contracts coming out. We just signed a bunch of new contracts with them. So renewing for another year and expanding our solutions with FCL. And we have Travis to thank for that. Travis, take it away. Tell us a little bit more.
There is certainly a lot to be excited about coming up for Morpheus Network. And part of the projects that I am involved with right now is everything Federate Co-op and Canada. So working through, and we're continually growing and scaling with them, and they're scaling with us. And so we've become each other's big part of our businesses. And so we just closed out several projects with them, but there are several already in process that we are working with. And a couple of them are their inbound supply chain, solving the barriers and solving the problems that they have with inbound supply chain, outbound supply chain, continuing efforts with their food certs, their farm to fork program. And so there's just a lot of programs that are coming through, a lot of projects that are ongoing. So very excited about continuing to grow with them and lead those projects. Some other projects that I'm excited about is the Mongolian government. And so we've already closed out two projects with them, and we're working on getting another one and potentially a fourth one started with them as well. And so it's fun and it's exciting to see us impact a region that is really needing our services, but it's having real world impact and global impact for them specifically. And then our Speed.Supply, seeing how that's going to be rolled out, again, is exciting. Some other things that are not project related that really gets me excited is building our internal systems and processes. And what do I mean by that is building a complete from scratch customer success program. And so that is ongoing with our customers, making sure that they are using platform, that they're getting their questions answered, that you know, they're successful, continually being successful using our platform and being a voice of reason for them. So building that process and that program from scratch is something that I'm ongoing, continually building on. But some other things is part of that is continually building on our internal process with handover from sales to implementation to just refining our entire process. And so those things, again, built from scratch that we are utilizing and watching roll out as we speak. So exciting times to be with Morpheus Network. Thanks.
Thank you, Travis. And next up is Justin, our head of product, who will give you a little bit more detail of what he's been building and why he never gets any sleep. Ever since he was boots down here in December, he has been heads down at his desk building Middleware.Supply, Speed.Supply, all of our dot supplies. And we are incredibly thrilled. We've been going through a lot of testing internally and with some of our beta community, trying to get some user feedback. The UI is tight, I got to say. It looks really, really cool. It's easy to use. The onboarding automation is second to none. We've really gone above and beyond integrating some cool technology into the new platform to make it easy to use and fun to use. So without any further ado, here's Justin to tell you a little bit more about it.
Hello, Morpheus Network community. It's Justin here, head of products. As we close out the first quarter, I want to spend some time really highlighting and celebrating the journey for myself joining in December, well, late December, but also, and more notably, to celebrate the incredible progress that this entire team has done in Q1 and then Q2 up to this point. This update isn't just going to be a summary of the achievements, but at the end of it, it will definitely be a testament of our hard work, our resilience, and our collective shared vision for the future. However, before we jump into it, I first want to express my gratitude, both our internal Morpheus Network team, and especially to you all, our community. For our internal team, they have been tirelessly working to enhance scalability and quality of this entire engine, especially as we prepare for the imminent launch of our SaaS platform. In Q1, we successfully revisited and refined our entire business strategy. This ensures that our product roadmap not only meets the industry standard, but strategically positions us to be an industry leader, not in the current moment, but also for the next few years. This process has been extremely demanding. However, the rigorous scrutiny that we've applied, we will definitely be yielding some long-term benefits, which we've already began manifesting. So I just want to say to our internal team, I appreciate everyone's hard work. It's going to be, once again, the rest of the year is going to be absolutely incredible. And I'm extremely excited for what's to come. And I'm sure you all are as well. Once again, I want to say thank you, everyone, both internal and to the community itself, that everyone's been patient. And for the ones who have been here since day one, more notably, thank you so much for continually being loyal to this lofty goal that Dan kind of started this company on, which is fix supply chain, you fix the world. And together, I truly believe that we're not just shaping the future of Morpheus Network, but we're redefining what is actually possible for the supply chain industry. So with that, I greatly appreciate everyone's time and looking forward to the rest of Q2 and going into Q3. Talk to you soon.
Thank you very much, Justin. And now, Dan, with our last update of the day, I think you're really going to love this one. Dan?
Hey guys, what's up? Dan Weinberger here again. I thought I'd sneak in with another quick video for you guys. Also want to talk about another exciting project. This is a collaboration between Morpheus Network, of course, and our new tech partner, Arbitrum. Fantastic crypto project, absolutely amazing team, very responsive. Excited to be working with them for a client, Neobution. Neobution is a European brand manager. They actually handle brands such as Logitech, even Google, handle some HP product as well. We actually did a microfiber traceability project with them. Goods being manufactured in Turkey, passive injection molding machines, the whole processing process in all those different facilities, all recorded on the digital footprint thanks to our technology, thanks to our platform, our traceability system, it allowed them to actually add certificates as well as live images of the actual products being shipped out. Really amazing project. Excited to be working with Andreas, the supply chain manager for Neobution. And once we have this implementation completed, we're moving on to new brands, some of the larger brands from Neobution as well. Once again, huge thank you to the Arbitrum team. Huge thank you to the Neobution team, especially to Andreas. And once again, guys, thank you so much. Have a great day.
Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. I know it was long, but I hope you found it informative and reassuring. And I hope we answered all of your questions. We will continue our AMAs this year. So look for those Google Forms to come out with your questions. We will pose them to Dan and to Noam. We can hopefully shoot something for July. We can do our next AMA. Until then, we'll be heads down getting Speed.Supply and Middleware.Supply out just as fast as possible. And of course, all of the marketing efforts around that launch and release, we will be letting you know about in very near time. So again, from everybody here at Morpheus Network, thank you very much for your support, for being a member of our community, and genuinely supporting our project. Until our next one, be safe. Take care. Bye-bye.